Yo, this is Gorilla NEMS, and this is how we took over America in 55 days with the Disrespect Tour. As always, you know, we started at the FYL store. First show was supposed to be Buffalo, but it was 6 feet of snow and it got canceled. So the first official tour date was Boston. After that, we was booked for a strip club. Then we went all the way up to Vermont in a blizzard. Then we went down to Philly during a blizzard, and I caught a cold. Went back home to Brooklyn for the dopest show of the tour. Hometown crowd, it was fire. Took a day off, then we was back outside. Cleveland, then Lansing, Michigan, then Chicago. Chilled out there for a couple days. You know, we got fam out there, did the podcast, did a couple club walkthroughs and all of that. Then we back on the road. Appleton, Wisconsin, horrible. They broke the back of our window in the Sprinter van when we was inside the club, and the promoter tried to put us in a crackhead hotel. Soon as we seen that, he said, we out of here. After that, we went to Minneapolis, Minnesota. Chilled out there, took a day off, relaxed. Drove through Iowa, and then we was in Kansas City. But there's two Kansas cities. There's one in Kansas and there's one in Missouri. But then we went over to the Missouri side and checked the homie Tech Nine. He showed us Wild Love, and then we was off to the races. Omaha, Nebraska, dope show. Denver, Colorado, super dope show. Fans had tattoos, all of that. Then we went to the mountains, Montana. Then we went to Idaho Falls, one of the top shows of the tour. They had an 8-year-old girl in the club. She knew all the words. We went to Salt Lake City, Utah, Portland, Oregon. Then we went up to Seattle. Then we went back down to San Fran. That was dope. Then we did LA, number two show of the tour. Then we hit Vegas for a couple days. Took some of that tour money, spent it. Some of us won, some of us lost, but all of us had a dope time. Then we hit Phoenix for a pop-up shop at Trill. Then we went to Albuquerque, New Mexico, and Hobbs, New Mexico. We also stopped at Roswell, New Mexico, chilled with the aliens for a little bit. El Paso, Texas, one of the top five shows of the tour. Then we hit San Antonio, then Dallas, then Austin, and then Houston. We checked the homie Bun B at Trill Burgers, shot a video there, hit the strip club that night. Then the next day in Houston, we checked Trader Truth. We just showed love all around the border. After that, we stopped in Louisiana, Mississippi, Mobile, Alabama. We just chilled for a couple hours in each spot. Then we stopped in Atlanta for the night, and I love Atlanta. After that, we had a show in North Carolina. Then we had to go back to New York City. Mom Dukes was having her birthday party, and I had to meet with Ava Rex. After one day, we drove back down to Florida. We hit Orlando, super dope pop-up shop. I'm definitely coming back. Then we hit Tampa for a dope show, and then we ended the tour in Jacksonville, Florida. Next day, back up to New York City, and that's how we took over America in 55 days. Besides performing at all these venues, every state that I went to, I dropped one of my Topps cards, and I signed it with the state so people know it was an exclusive drop. 55 days, 40 cities, 37 boxes of merch hand-to-hand all across America, 34 states visited, 46 signed top cards left, 12,000 miles driven, 20,000 jokes told, 700 fans voluntarily disrespected, drove through 3 blizzards, driving through the mountains, driving through ice, driving through tornadoes. It was crazy. The Disrespect Tour. Canadian Disrespect Tour starts in August. We outside.
Don't ever disrespect me. Ever, 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 ever disrespect me. Pussy. Don't ever disrespect me, you heard?